Hello and welcome to my channel. This is what we are going to create today. Let's see how to create this using After Effects. Before further proceeding, I would like to thank you for supporting me. If you are new to this channel, please do consider subscribing. That would be highly appreciated. Please don't skip the video. Please do watch the video completely. Let's not waste any more of the time. Let's get started. Create a new composition and name it as text placeholder. I am choosing a 1920 by 1080 composition with the frame rate of 30 and a duration of 6 seconds. Select the text tool and type in your text. I am typing in shatter. Turn off the transparency grid and central in the text. Create another composition, name it as shatter. Bring in the text placeholder into the shatter composition and search for shatter effect in the effects and presets panel and apply it into the text placeholder. Set the view to rendered, open up the shape property and set the pattern to glass. Set the repetitions to 30, diffusion depth to 0.3. Open up the force one property and set the strength to 2. Open up the force 2 property and set the strength to 2. Go to the physics property and set the viscosity to 0.8. Set the mass variance to 80% and the gravity to 0. Duplicate the text placeholder, search for tint effect and apply it into the below lying layer. Set the map white to color to black. Search for CC radial fast blur effect and apply it into the below lying layer. Turn on the transparency grid so that we know what we are doing. Search for drop shadow effect and apply it into the same layer. Set the opacity to 100%. Search for bevel alpha effect and apply it into the top text placeholder composition. Set the edge thickness to 5 and the light intensity to 1. Create another composition and name it as shatter 2 and bring in the shatter composition into the timeline. Again, search for shatter effect and apply it into the shatter composition. Set the view to rendered, open the shape property and set the pattern to glass. Set the repetitions to 50. Open up the force one property and set the strength to 8. Also set the strength of the force two property to 8. Open the physics property and set the viscosity to 0.5. Set the gravity to 0.2 and the gravity inclination to 90. Create another composition and name it as shatter 3. Bring in the shatter 2 composition into the timeline and right click and click on time and choose enable time remapping. Move the keyframe at the start of the timeline to 1 second 10 frame mark. Now create another composition and name it as final output. Bring in the shatter 3 composition into the timeline and make it as a 3D layer. Search for turbulent displace effect and apply it into the shatter 3 composition. At the start of the timeline, create a keyframe for size property and set the value to 200. Go to around 20 frames and set the size value to 2. Again, go to the start of the timeline and create a keyframe for evolution and go to the 20 frame mark and set the evolution to 1 full rotation. Search for CC light sweep effect and apply it into the shatter 3 composition. At the start of the timeline, create a keyframe for center and position the center as shown. Go to around 1 second and change the center value as shown. press here to bring up all the keyframes and select them and press F9 to easily ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Bring up the scale and rotation property and at the start of the timeline, create keyframes for scale, X rotation, Y rotation and Z rotation. Set the scale value to 1000, the X rotation to 25 degrees, Y rotation to 30 degrees and the Z rotation to 50 degrees. Go to around 25 frames and set the values to the default values. Now select all the keyframes and press F9 to easily ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Ramp preview this. That's good. Go to the shatter to composition and search for tint effect and apply the tint effect to the shatter composition. Change the map white to color 2, whatever color you like. Go to the final output composition and in the CC light sweep effect, change the light color to the lighter version of the color you chose. Now ramp preview this. It's looking nice. Create a new solid layer and name it as background. Bring down the solid layer below the shatter 3 composition. Search for fractal noise effect and apply it into the background solid layer. Set the fractal type to smeary and the noise type to linear. Set the contrast to around 250 and the brightness to 25. Open up the transform property and uncheck the uniform scaling and set the scale width to 700 and scale height to 1000. Set the complexity to 1 and at the start of the timeline, create a keyframe for evolution. Go to the end of the timeline and set the evolution value to 2 full rotations. Search for tint effect and apply it into the background layer and choose a color of your choice. Now ramp preview this. Create a new adjustment layer and bring it above all the layers. Search for CC vignette effect and apply it into the adjustment layer and set the amount and angle of view as per your choice. Now ramp preview this. That's good. Trim the composition to around 3 seconds and now ramp preview this. Yeah, that's looking good. That's it. Hope you enjoyed this video. Let's see the output once again. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and also click on the bell icon so that you get notified as soon as I post the videos. Click on the like button and share it with your friends. Comment down if you have anything to ask. And once again, thanks for being here and supporting me. This is Raudran signing off.